Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel in depth, chapter 26, Goal Seek. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. Well, we're working through the Excel in depth book, chapter 26, talking about some what if tools. I have a simple little model here where I can figure out the price of a car. I want to pay for it over 60 months, 5.25% interest rate, and what the monthly payment would be. This uses the PMT function, but we're not here to talk about the PMT function. I'm trying to get this car, but my problem is my budget only handles $425. And so I can start to try and find the price of the car that will yield $425 just using brute force. I can, for example, plug in $20,000, and that's too low. So maybe then try $22,500. A little bit too high. I can just keep going back and forth and back and forth, but there's a much, much faster way to go. Anytime you have a model like this where you have input cells that lead to a final value, we can have Excel find the right input value to lead to a correct answer. So it's back here on the Data tab under the What If dropdown, something called Goal Seek. Goal Seek. So we want to set cell B5 to $425 by changing cell B1. All right, so that's how Goal Seek works. When I click OK, it starts honing in on a value. It'll do it in less than a second. Bam, it's done. All right, so 22,384.93. Click OK to accept that, and we've now backed into it. Now, notice they did not change the formula at all. The formula is still there. The model's still intact. We can still continue to play what-if analysis, but it finds the right input cell to lead to that output cell very, very quickly. A great tool back here on the Data tab. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.